We'll let you do.
Yeah, it's amazing that I almost cut my throat.
No, you're not going to cut your throat, are you?
I said I almost cut my throat.
When? Just now?
Yeah, I just now with my hands. Oh, man. So later on, we got Ski Mask doing his crap with Josh Smith. They did this wrestling skit garbage. Bill, I'm sorry you have to be on the same show with that. We got that. That's a drag for you, Bill. You're here, and later on in the show...
First, you got to be patient. We'll
first,
then you got to be tolerant, you know? We're asking two things of you, patience and tolerance.
I'm sorry for you, because you got to be on the show.
See how many disgruntled emails I get after this.
Probably a lot. All right, so let's talk about what you're here for. You're the head of the film festival? Are you the head of the film festival?
That's correct.
Founder. How the hell did you get that job?
Oh, somebody couldn't do it.
Is it your brainchild? Are you the one that came up with the idea?
Yeah.
Well, that's how you got the job.
The founder.
The founder and creator of.
So you know, you're sitting around one day and decided, I don't have a film festival?
Well, you know, you hear things here and there over time and how people want to do this and do that and do that and never follow through. So
yeah, people are full of shit, aren't they?
Yeah, totally.
They always say they want to do these big, grandiose projects, and they don't do it.
I know. Well, if I get a quarter for every time, you know.
So many times you can deal with that. So I'm a doer, not a talker.
Wow.
Usually you hear...
We're talkers.
Yeah, we talk a lot. But we do stuff, too.
Well, that's good. There's nothing wrong with
that. I hate doing stuff.
Nothing wrong with talking.
Painful. Doing stuff is so hard.
See,
such hard work. I can't take it.
It is hard work.
Uh-huh.
Once you've committed, though, verbally, you know, it's kind of like you have to do it. It's set in stone. It's become the light.
No, I like to. I like to not do it.
Really?
I like to commit and then cancel.
Okay.
So, all right. Yep. So this is the Buffalo Niagara Film Festival. Is that what it's called?
Yep.
And then this is the second year.
This is our second.
And
we didn't know about it the first year. We were kind of surprised and flabbergasted.
But now it's
at
getting
the
all this.
Time.
And now it's getting all this, making all this headway, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we were testing the waters a little, you could so to say. And see how it was going to go and who we could bring in. And
who are you bringing in this year?
Lots of people.
Wow, yeah, but who are they? Lots of people, wow. The film festival will have lots of people coming in? Oh, my God, Bill, you're really doing some good work.
Some I can say, some I can't.
Okay, well, yeah, so Tom
Holland's coming back again.
Who?
Tom Holland.
Who's he?
He's the writer-director of Child's Play, Fright Night.
Oh, horror movie.
Tales
Is this all horror movies, this film festival?
We dedicated one day to science fiction, fantasy, and horror.
Right.
A whole day, which is taking place at the Riviera Theater. So we have a nice little slew of those type of filmmakers coming in.
Is that what the kind of movies you make?
No, some. I made a couple thrillers earlier, but we're moving on to some other bigger projects, you know, some romantic comedies. We have some period pieces. We got an animation.
What, that you're making?
Period pieces. Those are tough.
So you're a director, huh?
Absolutely.
What's that like?
It's painful, just like coming here. Yeah. Did I say that out loud? No.
Well, you're
well,
you're
what
a director.
Do you mean it's painful like coming here?
It's painful. Like this headset. No. No.
You're a director.
It's a chore. Coming here?
It's a chore just like anything. Yeah, absolutely.
Do you find it painful?
So this
painful?
Is a chore right now? He just said it was painful coming here and this headset's painful.
Yeah. We're joshing you guys.
Oh, you're joshing me.
Yeah,
we're what are you, the queen?
I'm happy to be here. Yeah, I'm happy to be here.
We're happy to be here.
I'm happy to be here. This is good. This is a good thing.
So you got a bunch of different venues for this Buffalo Niagara Film Festival. When is it, in March?
End of March, last week in March.
And there's a bunch of venues in Buffalo you're doing it, just not one place?
Oh, it's a couple places, we got the Riviera Theater in Tonawanda's. We got the Market Arcade, and then a couple we haven't confirmed yet, but we're deciding whether we're going to show some other types of films or some organizational type stuff in certain areas, but we didn't finalize that yet. So.
And how many movies do you show?
It'd probably be under 100, but I would assume somewhere between 70 and 100 films. The films are looking really good. We're on our last week of viewing and doing the pre-screening, and the films are just incredible.
You found a lot of good stuff so far?
Yeah, absolutely.
So it's all from out. It's mostly from out of town, though, right? Nothing
no,
to do with
so,
Buffalo,
no. There's
right?
a lot. No, there's a lot of local submissions that we had this time, which was a lot. Which was what we were missing a lot of the first time around. I mean, we had submissions from local guys.
I don't know why we didn't hear.
Quite a few,
we really didn't hear about it. Yeah. It was.
No, there wasn't a lot of advertising dollars. You know, at first, you know, it was something I put out of pocket to do and. You know, kind of put your money where your mouth is kind of thing. And I fed it, you know, so to take it off, and it worked out well, and you know, now we have organizational people helping. We got sponsors, you know, bigger sponsors.
Oh, that's good.
And money coming in, so it's a good thing. It's going to grow. It's going to keep growing.
So who are the other names besides this other guy who I didn't know who the hell he was?
Well, on
it's
the
not
horror
famous
day,
names. It's just names
horror,
I won't know, right?
Yeah, on the horror day, we got Gordon, Herschel Gordon Lewis coming in.
Oh, he's great!
Yep.
Oh, my God, he's 95 years old. He's coming here?
He's coming.
I want to French kiss him.
He's coming. He's in his
He's in advertising, isn't he?
Yeah.
I love that guy.
Yeah,
oh, my God, he's great. He's coming. Why are you telling that? Oh, my God.
You better not let him in. If he's
oh, I love him.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Woo!
You know that, and don't forget
that. I've never seen him.
Don't forget that band from that. Don't forget that band from Jamestown, 10,000 Maniacs. Huh? Wow. Okay, you got a real name coming, Bill. Why did you say in the first place? You mentioned Tom Holland. Where the fuck he is? You got a fucking legend coming in. What are you afraid you're supposed to mention that? Don't you know how to hype these things? You're supposed to mention that first.
I do. I wanted to give you some glory here yourself.
Jesus,
you gotta do it. You gotta do it. Gotta do it.
All right. And the rest of the utter no names?
Utter no names?
Yeah.
Utter
no names, wow. UDDER.
We got some people from The Natural coming.
Really? Barry Levinson? Robert Redford? Robert Duvall?
We haven't had exact confirmations on some of those, but
anyone big from the. You're not
Robert
taking...
Prosky's coming.
Who?
Robert Prosky.
Who?
He played the judge.
Oh, he was a judge?
The judge, yeah.
I don't know.
We have a couple others, but we didn't.
So not Redford?
We don't know yet.
You asked Bob Redford to come?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we've been in contact.
Why not?
Well, I know. He's in the
we've
film.
Hey, how about the Weinsteins?
We've been in contact with them as well? As well.
They're freaks.
They're coming.
They're coming?
No.
Oh.
I worked on Harvey Weinstein's first movie, The Burning.
Burning. With Holly Hunter and Jason Alexander as the Beaver.
I was an intern from school.
You probably know one of the taxi owner guys here, Bill Yonke.
Oh, I don't.
You probably do. Paul
doesn't
have any
memory. I was tragically born without a memory.
He has some interest in The Burning. We were just talking about
The
yesterday.
Burning. Oh my God.
The Burning.
Little did you know how Hollywood and the
Academy Award
winner.
I actually have a credit. As a production
it's still
assistant.
Still on TV every once in a while.
I've only saw it when I went to the premiere in New York.
Oh,
I never saw it.
They still show on television. They don't show anything on television. There's like, there's 800 channels out there. Jesus
It was just
Christ.
On last week.
Are you kidding me? Yeah. I'd love to see that again.
It was
again.
Just on last week.
Because I was actually in one of the scenes, too. I was a little younger.
Holy fuck.
Yeah.
I was a little younger back then.
Oh, that's good that you're doing. So you're a film fanatic? Is that what it is, Bill?
Well, I know quite a bit, but I wouldn't say a fanatic.
You're what, a buff?
A buff.
You're
an
aficionado?
Sort of.
How do you distinguish?
I have a lot of different levels. You know, I'm mostly a business person. So I tackle things mostly from the business end and then
I thought you're an
reverse,
artist.
So I am an artist.
You're mostly a business person, artist
but
second?
Most people can't make a living at being an artist. You got to go the other way first and then come back. You know, then you can do what you want to do.
Holy.
We know someone else like that.
Who is it, Jesus?
Yeah.
Jesus.
So, you know, it's a hard ground. Anybody who's an artist knows that ground. So it takes a long time. And not only this, but, you know, this festival thing and the production stuff that we're doing, you know, it just didn't, I mean, we're getting known now, but, you know, it was years ago, you know, that we started this, 8-9 years ago.
Yeah.
You know, the whole perception of this. And
it was 8-9 years ago you started the idea of it?
Well, not the festival, but it was only a couple, 2 years ago when the festival we started.
What was before that? You were just trying to help
production company.
Make,
yeah, I mean our
films
yeah,
and
my production company. Yeah,
Captures, what's it called?
Captures Entertainment.
Oh yeah,
Captures Entertainment. Yeah. So we had some great talent hooked up right away, and of course some of those deals went sour.
Of course, and, that's how life is. Sometimes it goes sour.
My first contact, Roddy Dangerfield.
Really?
Yeah.
He's dead
but
now.
But you didn't show him any respect.
You drove him to the grave.
We tried. We tried to show him respect. He went ahead and left us.
I didn't really like that guy too much. I'm glad he's dead.
He's
I celebrated when he died.
He was funny. You did not celebrate.
I broke out the Cheerios the day he died.
Cheerios. Yeah, he's a big Cheerio celebrator.
And milk.
Yeah.
You ever have Cheerios and milk?
Yeah, absolutely.
So tell me about your movie making. You made movies?
Sure.
And
What's your favorite project?
I don't
project?
Know anything about them, Bill.
My favorite project is probably the ones that haven't been done yet. You know, we've been working on it.
So you're not satisfied with the stuff you've made so far?
Well, of course. I mean, but they're learning.
You are satisfied with it.
Yeah, of course. I'm proud about everything I do. You know, it's,
oh,
it's,
my God. It's really?
Yeah, absolutely.
That's good.
What a winner you are.
Absolutely. I know.
I wish I could be like you. Did you just say you were proud of everything you've ever done?
I'm proud of everything, yeah. I wouldn't take it back.
Really?
Wow.
I would take everything back, practically.
Absolutely.
I would take my entire life back if I could just take it back.
Then we know what to expect.
Oh, my God. Yeah. I just think of it as, wow, that's good. I'm glad for you.
I'm happy.
And what did you do with these movies? Did you put them on DVD or video?
Some are. Lionsgate picked up one of my last projects.
Holy
fuck. So that's out there nationwide.
Wow, that's good.
Yep. What's that called?
It's excellent.
The Maze.
Oh, yeah, The Maze. That's right.
The Maze film.
That's right. That's you?
Yep.
Oh, that was something, buddy.
That was my... Yeah.
All right. Now, what's that about? That's like a bunch of people in a maze, right?
Yeah, it's actually
one little cornfield, right?
Yeah, so the whole set was pretty much a cornfield thing. But
yeah, I thought so.
It's about a couple kids.
That's why I said that.
Yeah, a couple kids would get caught inside, and
that's genius.
Yeah, it is.
Now you did like.
It was genius getting out of that mess.
You did the maze. You did the Maze 2. The Maze 3.
The Maze 2. Maze 1 and 2.
You got this idea for the Maze from that fucking commercial, right?
No.
We call it corn. Or you call it corn. You call it corn. We call it maze, right? You got it from that, right?
No, I don't even know what that is.
That's the Where Indian that commercial. The Indian comes on, the damn Indian, and says, "You." The damn Indian woman, and she's got a tear coming out of her eye, and she's.
No, that's a different one. The tear out of the eye.
You remember that commercial, right?
I don't.
Yeah. Oh, anyways.
I have no memory. You know that.
All right. Wow, you've done a lot. That's good.
Starting to do a real one.
Yeah, you're really moving. So you like being in Buffalo, or would you rather be out there in the world?
I've been everywhere.
You've been everywhere?
Oh yeah, I've been.
Holy
all over
shit!
The place.
That's impossible, isn't it?
Yeah, I came back.
You've been everywhere.
I've been. Is there any chance?
Have you been warmer places? And you've come back.
Yeah.
Oh, that's very.
So you like being here?
For now, I do.
Wow.
Yeah, but I went away just like everybody else did. Test the water, you know, see the country.
Right.
You know?
Did you notice it was just everywhere was exactly the same? Buildings, cars.
Good for you.
No. It's very different everywhere you go.
Right. Yeah,
everywhere
that's
you go. Even the states are different, you know.
Yeah.
The countries are really different.
Yes.
You know, you go out of the countries and things are, you're happy. You know, you come back here and you go, you know what, we don't have it so bad. You know, most of the time.
Oh, when you leave the country, you mean?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, let's get down to the real reason we're here.
Yeah, really.
We submitted our movie. You watched it yet?
Yeah. Which one is that?
It's called Sweet Jesus.
Sweet Jesus, no.
Did you watch it yet?
That's on for this week.
You didn't watch it yet? Because we,
I know, our mutual friend, Greg Lamerson, right? He will tell you it's a fucking masterpiece.
Okay.
This is what my boss said to me when she watched
it. Am I supposed to grease the judges to do this?
Well, whatever. You're in charge, man. I'm saying. Okay, so this is what my boss said to me after she watched it. She said it's about Jesus Christ, of course, and she said it made her think about how to be a better person and lead a better life.
Okay.
Never heard that one.
It's a movie, man. It's a movie.
You know, the story, Miracle on 34th Street, right, about Santa Claus. So it's the same concept. You know, those people that made
same concept as Miracle on 34th Street.
Those people except that
Jesus.
Made that movie didn't necessarily believe in Santa Claus, although their Santa Claus was real.
We don't necessarily believe in Jesus.
And we don't necessarily
believe in Jesus.
But
who cares? You made a movie.
Our Jesus is Jesus in the movie. Mm-hmm.
Well, we try to portray him basically like he is.
My other friend said,
who was a devout Christian, she said when she watched our Jesus in the movie, she said it was the way she pictured Jesus her entire life.
Oh.
I mean, he doesn't have long hair. He's like he's a modern Jesus.
All right, so get watching that, Bill.
Is it modern Jesus?
Modern Bill. Jesus. Jesus comes to Niagara Falls.
It's not shaving as a Mohawk or nothing.
No, Jesus comes to Niagara Falls. So he's a kind of a Boy Scout.
He's a tender Boy Scout, you said?
Well, good.
I'm kind of a Boy Scout.
I thought you said a tender Boy Scout.
Looking forward to viewing it.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Get on there, man!
All right.
I watched The Maze 4 12 times.
I'm going to watch it tonight.
Now that we put him on the spot.
Well, it's painful for you to be here, but other than that, how was it? Other than the pain. Good. Was there any pleasure in this, or just all pure pain?
Oh, it's just the three accidents I almost got in on the way here.
Oh, no. What did happen?
That's nothing to do with us. Don't blame us for that.
Were you talking on the phone and eating at the same time?
Yeah, because he's one of those producer-director.
No, I was in a hurry to get here, and then we got delayed.
Oh, I know.
Bill, I got to say this. Bill, you're not going to believe this because you think...
Why? What happens? I know show business. You know what? You hurry up to wait. I love it.
This is the fastest we ever started a show ever.
Is it really?
In 13 years.
All right.
So we don't consider this a delay.
Yeah,
I'm going to tell you that right now.
I'm going to set my double next time first. So then I can just kind of
Set your stand-in.
I'm
going
to go to the bathroom
time.
And then come back.
Yeah, we could have had your stand-in sitting here the whole time.
There we go.
Setting the cameras up and lights.
Cardboard box.
All right, Bill, good luck with the Buffalo Niagara Film Festival in March.
Absolutely.
Rock on, baby.
Looking forward to it.
All right, clock.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Good to meet you.
Nice meeting you guys.
Oh, you thought he was being...
No, I'm a goof.
Oh, I thought you thought he was being phony with you.
No, I'm a goof.
All right, so Josh Smith is here with me and Paula. And
I'm often a goof.
He's going to bore us as usual. Go ahead, Josh.
Hi, Josh.
You're responsible for this, aren't you, Greg? You're responsible for this. He's not back.
I am.
Somebody's helping him. He wasn't here last week. He's not here this week. Somebody's helping him. Why? How did this stuff get here, Greg? Get us out of here. How did this stuff get here, Greg? Somebody's helping him. Is it you, Greg Stroz? Do I have to take you out this week, huh? Now forget you. You're old decrepit. I don't need to take
medication.
You out. Was it you, Paula? I think you're helping him.
Medication.
You're saying how cute he was last week. I think you've got a crush on Ski Mask. You're helping Ski Mask, aren't you? How did this get here, Paula? I think you're helping him out. Tell me whose phone is here. Tell me, Jim Prey. It was Jim Prey. He's conspicuous by his absence. Jim Prey. Where has he been, Greg? I think he's helping him out. I think he's helping. How did this get here? Maybe it's Playboy Ken Vaughan. Maybe since he's moving to Vegas, he wants to pull one big prank on me. He's out to get me. It's Playboy Kenny Vaughan, isn't it? Isn't it, Greg Stroz? You know what's going on here, Greg Stroz. Who got this here? Who was responsible for the TV last week? You know what? There's nothing behind that curtain. There's nothing behind that curtain. It wasn't there anything last week. It was a trick of the mind. It was a trick of the light. There's nothing back there this week either. Somebody told him, I'm going to get to the bottom of Greg Sterlace. Who's back there, Greg Sterlace?
Therapy, Josh.
I enjoy his energy, don't you?
Therapy.
His high energy level.
You see? There's nothing back here. There's nothing back there. You see? Nothing back there. Oh, oh. Say uncle.
We used to have a nice, peaceful show in the old days.
That was pretty energetic, I must say, for a skit. All right, clop.
I've had my ass full of that Josh Smith character. He's a character. He's a character. I'm real. He's the TV character, not me. Oh, he was calling me Chuck last week. Well, I got something to say about that. Well, you can call me Ski, or you can call me Mask, or you can call me Ski Mask, or you can call me Grand Ayatollah Ski Mask, or you can call me Grand Ayatollah Ski Mask Turd Bacon, or you can call me Ayatollah, or you can call me the Grand Ayatollah, or you can call me the Grand Ayatollah Ski Mask, or you can call me Turd Bacon, or you can call me the Pope of Riverside. Or you can call me the head pumpkin, or you can call me Ski Mask, but you doesn't have to call me Chuck. You know, we should call you, celebrated our rock star. We're going to call you the Rated G Castrato, because a castrato is a singer who has been emasculated, just like I emasculated you in front of TV audience. This is the Emasculation Proclamation Declaration, son. You said you were a big game Africa hunter, and you got the big mastodon of the ski mask. Well, I too went to a very special place, and I found this book, Close Up. It taught me what I needed to know to conquer you. It's White Witch Doctor, and I learned White Witch Doctor, Riverside Hoodoo Voodoo, and this thing, like Screaming Jay Hawkins, I put a spell on you, and now your mind is mine. You see, you wear that thing around your neck, I tricked you. When the hell do I ever wear that blue ski mask? Me and Dudley cast a magic spell, a rather magic Riverside Hoodoo spell on it, and it made you crazy, and you're all paranoid. And you ain't coming back, son. You're paranoid, like the Black Sabbath album. Because, close up, I took out Saddam Hussein with two of my bucket men. That's me putting that noose on him. If I can take out a great dictator of the world, I can take out the Rated G Castrato. Clop. Clop.
How was your week, darling?
All right, anyways, we're
adventurous.
Huh?
It was adventurous.
Adventurous.
You had an adventurous week for once?
Yes.
Really?
But you never had one before.
What
have
did you do?
Spencer had to go to the porn store. The one on Elmwood.
He had to go to the porn store?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
We go in.
I heard Drummer used to work there.
My drummer used to work there.
Yeah.
For Manal Pudding?
No.
No, her drummer.
My drummer.
Lindsay.
Lindsay.
Oh.
She's
no, no,
there.
No. Somebody that... Hey, do you mind?
Her boyfriend's an anal pudding, though.
You're blocking my view here.
Her boyfriend's an anal pudding. Maybe that's what you're thinking of.
Tell me the porn store.
Well, anyways, Spencer had to go there and buy something.
He had to go to the porn store and buy something.
One of them big, giant vibrators for her, you know?
A giant
Yeah. Well, we're in there.
An issue.
And we're walking around, and the guy behind the counter was like, hey, aren't you from that TV show? I'm like,
you?
What TV show? And I said, no. And I walked away. And then when I walked around, I thought about it. I was like, what TV show? The Greg Sterlace Show. It's like, yeah.
So it was your first recognition.
And but no, he's, I don't know his name, but he's with anal pudding.
Biff Titzel.
Oh.
Thin Biff glasses, thinner Biff than Titzel. Mine. Wears a Kango, goatee, like beard. He mentioned your name.
The Count of Monte Fisto.
He mentioned you.
Of course he did.
I just didn't get his name.
I'm a legend.
How could he not?
So that was the adventurous week that you went to a porn store?
Well, yeah, that they mentioned the show and him.
It made him happy.
It's not anal pudding.
He's not used to that. It's not normal.
So you never get recognized on the streets, Ken, from television? That was the first time ever, right?
Yeah, a porn store, huh?
So, I mean, you've been on...
A porn store, yeah.
But, I mean, you've been on TV week after week for, like, 8 months, and when someone says to you, aren't you from TV, and you say no?
Well,
I mean, you know you've been on television
the
for 8 months,
Greg Sterlace
right?
Show, sure, fine.
But yeah. Didn't you realize you were on television the last 8 months? When someone said, I saw you on TV, you didn't realize that? Do you think this has all been like a game or something? Where this airs on television, you know?
Happy hour with headsets.
It's hard to believe, now that I think about it. This is going to air on television, real television.
Like people are
people flip by. This is on channel 20.
Hey.
What?
Don't raise your voice to me.
I'm not raising my voice to you. I'm just saying, isn't it amazing?
You were just yelling a few minutes ago.
Yeah, but he's not
yelling.
Keep
it down.
You,
it's okay.
All right, clop. All right, we're back with from the White Trash Reservation.
Where'd the White Morris Day go?
Will you shut the fuck up? From the White Trash Reservation.
The dude.
The Ayatollah Turd Bacon. And then we got Tom Stroz, who's
Tom
not
Stroz.
The Ayatollah Turd Bacon. Okay.
He's not the Ayatollah.
From the White Trash Reservation of Kaisertown, Tom Stroz. Let's have a round of applause for Tom Stroz. Two freaks, no waiting.
Double penetration.
You. You love being the center of attention, don't you, Tom?
I'm just
That's your favorite
happy
thing.
Visitor.
Tom, how's the? You're looking for a woman. How's that going for you? You found anyone yet?
Not yet, but I'm getting there.
Oh,
I'm getting
that's
there.
Good.
Now, what does getting there mean?
Narrowing it down a little bit?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm taking it step by step.
And what does that mean?
12-step program.
It sounds like people tell
Alcoholics
me spirituality
Anonymous.
Is everything. It doesn't mean anything. You're weeding things out or what?
Ten steps to really finding the woman.
What are the 10
are
steps, Tom, to finding the right
the
woman?
Are you in the area or are you like looking all over the world?
No, I'm within the area.
Kaisertown?
Kaisertown, Chickawaga, West Seneca.
Wow, oh, you're exotic.
What, you know, what type of
exotic type girls?
Have you tried Riverside yet?
No, I haven't. Good
Do
women?
It.
White trash women. Do you like white trash women, Tom?
You like them big and smelly, hairy, mean?
No.
Riverside's
the top for you. You don't like big, hairy, smelly women?
Yeah. You don't like my mother? My grandmother?
No.
My sister? No. My aunts?
I didn't say
You're
that.
You're insulting my family, pal? You thought I did that.
He didn't say anything.
Bring G.K. Strati.
He didn't say anything.
No, what am I going to do to you, pal?
What kind of woman are you looking for?
Yeah.
Italian.
One that breathes. Breathing one?
Yeah, breathing one, yeah. Alive.
Alive.
A living Italian
Not dead.
Woman. That's good. A living Italian
So, Tom, Nelly? You want someone Italian so they won't be able to speak English? Is that what it is?
No, Italian.
Just Italian American.
Oh, you mean Italian American?
Well, they could be.
Why? Because of the mustache?
No.
Hey, you're talking about my mother again?
I didn't say anything about your mother.
Because
your mother's the only woman with a mustache in the world. Come on, get real.
Because they're
No.
You're insulting my family.
I'm insulting you.
Because Italian women are
Catholic. Yeah, you're insulting me by insulting my relatives.
Yeah, they could. You know, they could be from Italy themselves too.
Then you wouldn't have to deal with any of their bullshit talking. You would just go blah 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 in Italian. You wouldn't know what they're saying. That's great.
Like Benito Mussolini with big tits.
What?
Like Mussolini with big tits.
There are many who can speak their own language and American real well.
American? There's no such thing as American,
well,
Tom.
Like a Native it's American.
American English. Yeah.
American English. Okay. What are the 10 steps? Tom, what are the 10 steps to finding a woman? You said there were 10 steps earlier. What are the 10 steps?
Step one. Come on, pal. Step one.
You got to search. You're going to search out who you're looking for.
Search out who you're
WAP.
Looking
for.
Do you want a WAP or Guinea?
Porno book.
What?
Look at the porno book and check the porno book out
website.
First.
Website.
Porno book.
You got to decide what kind of features you like, what kind of qualities you like.
What kind of features do you like,
Mustache. Nipples the size of Reese's peanut butter cups with hair sprouting out of them.
Oh, yeah. That sounds charming.
That's what I'm looking for.
Come to Riverside,
really?
Friend.
No!
Want to date my sister?
Are you really?
Hey, I saw one in here that looked good.
We just don't know who the fathers are.
Yeah, why don't you call her out from that book from the 70s?
Hey, look at the 70s porn, dude.
Yeah, this one looks good.
She's probably very old by now. If she's
that,
in
that's
there now.
35 years ago, Tom.
35 years ago?
Yeah.
Probably still alive.
Could be.
Is there an age range, Tom?
Oh, from like 30 to...
30? It's a little young for you. You're
30
in your 50s.
55.
But you're 52. You don't. Who are you to be with a 30-year-old?
Okay, 35.
You're old enough to be your father.
Okay, 35 to 55.
Okay, it's more like
it. Don't matter what age they are.
Paula says there's a 10-year. Should be a 10-year window.
Old enough to breathe.
So it's really for you. Should be 42 to 52.
Yeah,
very nice.
I like the 10 years either way because you know why? Because then you don't have that generation gap.
Right. Exactly. You should be able to...
I feel it. It's making me feel special.
You're feeling like Josh Smith, and you're going to lose your mind and go paranoid.
I feel special.
Chuck,
I've never felt special before.
Chuck, we're trying to have fun with Tom.
Yeah,
you can try.
You should be able to hook up with somebody in your generation as much as like 5 years older or younger than you.
Well, 10 years younger or 10 years older, because then you have at least some things in common.
Absolutely.
Because, you know...
Really, What things would people have in common with you? You're a religious fanatic. We know that. Anything else?
What religion?
There's a lot of Catholic. There's a lot of religious people. A lot of good religious people.
So what else? What are your other interests?
What else do you like besides? I'm trying to say we know that a woman's got to be a religious fanatic.
I like
interest in mustaches.
Mustaches
and religious fanaticism. Those are two things Tom
wants. I like
Mussolini with a mustache.
I like a woman.
They're female.
I like a woman who likes to bowl.
Bowl, wow.
Yeah, who likes the
Riverside?
Yeah,
play pool,
Kaisertown,
the
home of bowling.
Play pool, bowl. Yeah, you'll find women in.
There's a lot of bras like that in Kaisertown. Yeah,
play bowl and play. Or at least they will pretend to.
But they're not very feminine though. Those women are they?
Well,
bowling and
eight ball.
Bowling, pool, and religious fanaticism. The top three. What else?
How about chess?
Chess. Listen, baby, I like to play some chess with you. What? That's so boring.
That's
chess.
That's romantic.
Chess is romantic?
It's romantic that he wants to play chess with them.
All right, we'll go play some chess tonight then, Paula.
I don't know.
Did you know that chess was structured after football? Did you know that? Yeah, chess is like
what?
What? Are you out of your
war
mind?
Games. It's
all the time machine factor.
Chess was originally a war game.
That's right, yeah, the time machine. Then the NFL, like the king of the Ukraine who invented chess went back to the time machine to like see the Bills lose 5 times in a row. Best Bill, OJ, he didn't win 5 Super Bowls in a row like Jim Kelly.
But if you ever see the way the runners run in football,
they run like chess pieces.
Yeah,
they fly
exactly.
Across the board. They don't have legs or nothing. The one looks like a horse.
Straightforward, diagonally, and exactly.
A lot of football players look like a horse.
Tom, chess did nothing to do with football.
Who's a queen in chess? Who's a queen in football?
Nuts.
There's a lot of queens in football. Are you kidding me?
Name some.
He knows more than I do.
They don't come out of the closet too often. All right, you have to play chess, bowling, pool, religious fanaticism.
Can they drink alcohol or no?
Tom, would you date a black woman?
They're all right.
Tom, what about another race?
None with a mustache.
Tom, what about another race? Native American, African American, Asian American, Mongolian American,
Martian,
Martian,
Jewish.
Jewish? We've been dating any of these other races.
Well, what about Jewish? How could they? How could you do that? Because I thought
Tom,
that you,
can you date any of these other races? That's what I'm asking.
It was
you.
Very important that somebody be have
what
the same
like,
religious beliefs.
Tom,
yes, there are
Mongolians.
There are modern day Jewish people who are.
So you
Catholic.
would date another race?
Who are Catholic?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you have to be a Jewish Catholic.
Yeah,
Jewish Catholics are great.
That's
so you would date another race, Tom?
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. You're open minded. Okay. Have a good life. Thanks for being on. You'll be here every week.
Have a real
on,
nice
right?
life. Come to Riverside and meet Mussolini.